So sleep should be a time for recreation, unwinding and restoring energy levels. If you have stress at work, sleep helps you recover. Unfortunately, poor sleep and job stress often go hand in hand. That's why this next conversation is absolutely important, especially on a day when all you workers take a break from the everyday work hustle. My guest is Dr. Collins Ajiman. He's an industrial and organizational psychologist and a lecturer at the Department of Psychology, University of Ghana, Lagos. I just want to begin by asking, how bad is work stress today? Don't use me as an example.
Well, I had wanted to ask you whether, Mama V, you are stressed yourself. And I was wondering, during this morning show, I'm sure you woke up very early.
I did, yeah.
And if you consistently do that, you cannot tell me you've never felt stress. And I must say, work stress is a common phenomenon. Whenever we talk of, I am a psychologist, so allow me to sell my profession.
Please do.
I do ask people when I consult for organizations, have you ever sought the assistance of a psychologist? And people go like, oh, not really. But if we have ever been stressed, we have a psychological condition. And so psychology is in our lives. Every aspect of our lives, there is psychology. And getting stress is a psychological condition which demands, and in most cases may well run for, a psychological consultation or support. And just as you ask, have I ever been stressed? I myself, yes, we do. It's normal to get stressed.
Okay. And so there's good stress?
Yes, there is good stress and there is bad stress. But in most cases, our attention is drifted to the bad stresses. So in terms of work-related stress, it's a lot. And today is May Day.
Yeah.
Workers may be happy sitting at home, looking at programs, events that are organized and all that. But I must say there is a lot to it than just saying workers get stressed.
Okay.
And foremost, let me explain to the our hearers what is stress. As humans, we do have personal resources. We do have social resources. And these two resources help us to manage the demands that come on us. And so if you are married, you may have home-related demands. As a worker, you are supposed to be here very early in the morning as a media person. That is a work-related demand. You may have aging parents and their daily concerns, my rheumatoid arthritis, SSB, what I say is as a bro, P.
All BP.
These, exactly, my BP, all these also bring you another demand. If you have children and caring for these children, who to hand them over before you go to work and all that, another demand. A complex husband or a complex wife, another demand. How do you manage life issues? Another demand. As a media person, how do I always remain on top? The way I dress, how I carry myself, posting the latest pictures on Facebook, another demand. All these demands come on us. Depending on who you are, the work you do, you may have varying demands.
Okay.
So your ability, personally or socially, to use these resources to manage these demands shows whether you get stressed or not. And in most cases, the feelings or the experiences we have when our demands exceed these personal or social resources we have make us say, I am stressed.
Ah.
I hope the point is clear.
Yes, absolutely.
So now let's look at all the employees we have. Let's look at all the workers who are home watching us. Let's imagine all the people we have met who are workers. They do many of these things we've spoken about. So to what extent can we say that stress is a critical subject to discuss at the workplace? If you look at a worker, time schedule can be a stress. And in talking about stress, let me mention that we have what we call a stressor. A stressor is an event or a situation that causes you stress. an event that makes you feel I don't have enough resources to deal with it.
Okay.
That is a stressor. Or a situation that just happened and makes you feel you are powerless.
Mm.
That is a stressor. And at the workplace, there are a number of stresses.
Yeah.
A number of events, a number of situations.
People.
People. And so I usually ask people I consult for, what causes you stress? Is it worse, people, time, or seasons?
Is this something that you can easily tell or know?
You can. I always say we need to take an introspection of ourselves.
Mm.
We need to evaluate ourselves. So if I ask you, Mama V, what causes you stress? Is it the words said by people or the people themselves? Is it perhaps time, a particular time in your life that because of what is happening causes you stress? Or getting yourself in a particular place that also gets you stressed? We need to evaluate ourselves and get to know what causes us stress.
Mm.
So at the workplace, we should remember the bedrock of psychology, understanding the human behavior. Every single employee is that individuals differ. In psychology, individuals vary because of two things: your personality, who you are, and the environment that shaped you.
Mm.
So these two things causes variations between Mama V and Dr. ABC.
Mm. So if we're working in the same environment,
exactly,
the environment could cause me stress.
Exactly.
Just the workplace environment.
Exactly.
But it may not be the same for you, even though we're both in the same space.
Good, you've gotten the point. So we differ in our reaction to these stresses.
Mm.
And so our reaction to these events, these situations, brings about the stress.
Mm.
And there should be variation in how we appreciate these stresses. And let me say that work-related conditions, a complex boss. Imagine having two bosses. One is a reflective one who will listen to you, appraise whatever subject you bring, whatever issue there is, and give you a response. Mm. And we have a lot of these reflective bosses. We also have reactive bosses. They are not patient at all. I have worked with a number of bosses in my life, working in different universities. And you may have a reactive boss. They don't have patience. They think they know it all. You start a discussion, and he brings it to a conclusion. Having the kind of leadership you have, the kind of leadership style you experience, can be a stressor.
Mm.
Between a reflective and a reactive boss. Between a transactional leader who just says, do this, I give you that. Or someone who appeals to your heart. Someone who appeals to you.
Mm.
You feel obliged to work without necessarily contemplating on what you will get. A transformational leader. Between these two, one can cause you stress.
Mm.
The environment around which we work can also cause a stress. Sometimes you go to the workplace and there's so much tension. We spend about a third of our life at the workplace. And so if you do 8 to 5, one third of your life is at the workplace.
Mm.
We structure our time with the workplace. We make meaning at the workplace. We try to form social connections at the workplace. The workplace serves as a means by which we get something small to manage our lives, manage our finances. This is what work does for us. So if work-related conditions brings us stress, then we are not doing ourselves much good. And so it's about time, as we celebrate, people look at May Day, reflect on work-related conditions, we need to evaluate what are the things that causes us stress.
Yeah, but can you control the stresses?
To some extent. And just as I mentioned, we can have individual induced stress. We can have organizational induced stress. And for the sake of talking about workers today, let's concentrate on just these two.
Yeah.
An individual induced stress is certain things we ourselves bring upon ourselves. I am a worker. You know, my research, 4-year research, shows that media personnel, you are paid very poorly.
True.
But you don't talk about it. So
who will listen?
Well, the point is, you are good in talking about others' problems. You don't talk about your own problems.
That's a fact.
And that is the problem with media. Mm. If I begin to unleash my findings about you, media personnel, I'm sure if I don't take care, your producer will call you behind the scenes without me hearing.
Fortunately, it's May Day.
Exactly.
It's
May Day,
so
we are free to talk. We are free to talk.
Okay, yes, including the
media
issues.
Yeah, so you are very right. Individual induced stress, we can control it. Given the work I do, if I'm poorly paid, why would I want to build 4 or 5-bedroom house, each with toilet and bath? Is it a guest room? Is it a guest house? These are some of the individual induced stresses we can avoid. The kind of lifestyle we want to have when we don't have the means, we can stress ourselves. So living beyond our means, we just introduce stress on ourselves. I always tell parents, is it compulsory your child should go to the most expensive school? What do they offer? Think of from age 0 to age 2 or 2.5 or 3 years. Some parents struggle just to pay fees you cannot imagine. But ask yourself, what do these children learn? 2 years, up, down, up, down. They are tired, they sleep. Why do we have to stress ourselves if we don't have the means? Majority of people who are the so-called great men, let's do a sample and find out where they came from. Some come from my village, PSK, Patasasis Yanzikokobin. What kind of level of support did they get? Their parents gave them time at home. And that was another form of orientation. It reduced the stress of struggling to pay so much. And that is why corruption will be difficult to conclude. If every parent is struggling to pay higher fees than the salary every month, what do you expect? Then we will try to cut corners. We will try and ensure that we take more from people and get these things sorted out. These are self-directed stresses.
So living within your means.
Let's live within our means. And this is what I'm saying to all workers. Let's live within our means. You know, we were talking, I just listened to your jingles, and one of my colleagues was talking about the fact that only 1.5 million Ghanaians have the prospect of having an insurance package when they grow old and leave the workspace when they retire. It's a worry. We need to begin to think about tomorrow. If we do that, we avoid the self-induced stress. That will come that I'm now 50, 55, where do I go and sleep? We must start now and keep life simple. Some people may decide to keep their life simple and plan toward the future. If you build 3, 4, 5-bedroom house, when your children grow, you are struggling to pay their school fees, they will not live with you, they will leave.
True.
Who will inhabit that big space you provide? It becomes a stress, sir, and you may not even be able to manage it. So individual directed stresses, we can deal with it.
Yeah.
Now let's look at the organizationally directed stresses. And I speak to the so-called bosses. If I am a boss, I should remember, I will not be a boss forever. The way sometimes some managers lead, it is not the best. We must be remembered for the legacies we are leaving. In Ghana, my own research indicates that when it comes to how employees view the sense of fairness, whether I'm being treated well at the organization, it's not about how much we give to our employees. It's not about how well we carry out procedures in getting things done. Ghanaians prefer interactional fairness. That is how we say it in organizational psychology. How I am being respected. Am I being engaged on the job? Am I involved in decision making? Are we consulted as employees when weightier decisions are being made? Or are we just interested in how much money did we save? How much money did we generate? That in itself doesn't help. It's about effective and efficient stakeholder management. These are some of the things organizationally we should begin to look at. We should begin to now look at how we can reduce the stress levels of our employees. We should go beyond you have started work. how did things go? We should go beyond that. Sometimes we need to go beyond to understand the individual employee we are working with. How many managers will leave their big seat? Get to know the ordinary employees they are working with. Without these employees, we are nothing. And so I always say, especially to management, we should begin to take active interest in the people we work for. To deal with stresses, we must connect at an emotional level with the employees we do have. This is something we are not good at. A good word said to an employee is enough to take the employee the next 1 year, and not necessarily how much we pay them. Trying to understand their home situation. How are you managing your family with work? We know you just gave birth. How are you adjusting? Even asking this question is enough to help these employees feel that, oh, my boss thinks about me. We want to connect at an emotional level. And there are other strategies to deal with stress, and I'm sure you may have some.
Well, my guest is May Day, it's Workers' Day. We thought, let's talk about something related to the job that ordinarily we will not talk about. So Dr. Collins Ajimang is my guest, and we're talking about work-related stress. I know that you can connect on all the levels of this conversation. So we're going to activate the phone lines so you can join us on 0302-211-6912. But first, we hit the streets. We want to hear the voices from out there. We'll come back. I have some more questions to ask. There are times that we're also planning for the future. So we're doing so many things right now because of the future that, you know, we dream of. Those are also stresses. How do we manage that? You're working, you're schooling, you have a family, you have all these things happening, and you're always stressed. How do you deal with that? First, let's listen to the voice on the streets.
I believe there is opportunity. I see opportunities of improvement. If you close at 5 from Ridge and you stay on the outskirts of Accra, it will take you, say, 3 hours to get home. The same applies when you're coming to work. I believe if we had trains and trams, you know, deployed in Ghana, it would take off this burden and also save us some productive hours. Yes, there are. However, like I pointed out, if you spend productive 3 hours in, 3 hours out, wake up every day at say 4:30 a.m. to beat the traffic, how productive can you be at work? What kind of stress management exercises would there be to relieve this kind of stress? 4:30 every day. 5 times in a week, sometimes 6 times. The weekends are not spared because there'll be other social events you'll be attending. So you are always maxed out. And, you know, it's only a matter of time. You're going to develop these, you know, lifestyle diseases like diabetes, hypertension, etc., etc. If you had a system where, you know, you could travel, you know, say...
Some of the workers too don't remain their loyalty to the companies here, and it affects the companies a lot, because as workers and the management are involved in the operations of the company, there should be loyalty. Some of the workers themselves break that bridge, and so managers do not have that trust in them. Managers too, some of them don't communicate effectively with their employees, because you have to communicate with them so that you know what they are, because sometimes people feel inferior about themselves because you don't regard them. When it happens like that, it serves as a platform for them to outline their problems.
With where I work, we have a gym session that's on Wednesdays and Thursdays. After work, the workers go there to release stress, and also I think 2 times in a year, the first and the second, the latter part of the year, we organize health walks. Yeah, so I think that's what my company basically do to help relieve stress of the workers. It's free. Yeah. So far as you're a staff with the company, they cater for it. Yeah, it's doing very, very well.
Well, the challenges confronting Ghanaian workers are quite varied. We know conditions of service are not that good in the country. Currently, employers are demanding more. They want workers to actually earn what they work for, so that at the end of the day, whatever you are paid at the end of the month must be commensurate to whatever you are giving at the end of the month. So there is pressure over there. Most organizations are introducing performance appraisal systems to ensure that workers don't just come and then roam about and at the end of the month get paid. Research has proven that currently Ghanaian workers are experiencing 160% more stress compared to their counterparts 10 years ago. To resolve some of these challenges, I would suggest that most corporate organizations should put in place stress management programs. Some organizations are actually introducing power nap systems. Some are introducing some aerobic type of activity on Fridays just to make sure that workers will stretch and be able to release tension. And then also some organizations are also putting together guidance and counseling systems in the organization so that staff with emotional and psychological problems can go there and meet a professional so that they can be helped as to how to manage their stress.
All right, so some voices from the streets, really important. And we want to also talk about sometimes you're not so sure, Dr. Ajiman, even though you have a job, you're not sure about the security of what you have. You're thinking ahead and you're trying to do everything possible. That could also bring some stress, correct?
Yes, I agree with you, Mama Vie, and especially if we think of what happened recent years in our financial sector. We have actually supported a lot of these victims, and stress is a bit high, not just stress, what we call common mental health disorders. Anxiety is another, because you don't know when you lose a job.
Yeah.
And so work-related issues, as far as job security, job insecurity is concerned, is one of the predictors of stress. And it is not out of place to think that if you don't have a job, you feel stress. If you have a job, you also feel stress, because you don't know the fear of the unknown, and that is very common. And even if you have the job, there are targets. Go to the banking sector, go to the insurance sector, media industry. There are targets. If you make a lot of mistakes on air, I tell you, your producer will call you. They do that behind the scenes. We don't see. Behind the scenes, they give it to you. They appraise whatever you do. Clients were calling. They were phoning in. They say they didn't like your accent. What have you? So there are targets, expectations. So if you have the job, you are not even sure.
Yeah.
Will you be the face of Joy News in the next 2 years? Was it you 3 years ago? Was it you last year? Is you today? So the fear of the unknown, the fear of tomorrow, also introduces another stress.
This thing that I say, that there will always be a better you.
Exactly.
There will always be a more confident, more qualified you who is also equally capable of doing what you're doing.
And that is why I'm not surprised one gentleman said, Ghanaians today feel much stressed than previous years.
Yeah.
And it's expected. As we move on with technology increasing, with high Eurocentric lifestyle and all that, it's expected that these things will increase our stress.
Let's take some phone calls. Maxwell Apia is in Techiman. After Maxwell, I'll come to you, Abdul Fatal. But Maxwell, good morning. Thank you for calling.
Good morning, Mama V. How are you?
I'm very well, thank you.
Wow, very, very great. Joy News has always been doing what I like. I don't know why. And good morning to Dr. Too. He's always solved my problem this morning for me. We discussed this thing at work yesterday, and then the main problem of Ghanaian workers, I think, is the inclusion in decision making. That is the main problem. It's all about money. When the worker feels he's part of the whole process of the work, he's somehow confident enough that whatever he goes, he thinks, well, his job is secured. But you will be there, you will sleep, and the next morning they will tell you, the whole process has changed. You are not going here. You are going here. It looks like you've been used like a robot. That's how the networkers have been treated. The bosses always feel like they are bosses. So they tell you early 4 a.m. you have to start work at 8, they will tell you 4 a.m., you are not coming, you are going here. Is it good? Is it fair? It's happening everywhere. I don't know if there should be a law that suppress you are employed. You should be part of decision making. I don't know why you should be part. Mm. Anything that is there, they should take into consideration. Where I'm working at the moment, all the work we are done by the small guys, as in coach, the small guys. But you sleep and then they will call you early in the morning. When you are on your way going to where they will say you are not coming, you are going to this community. It's a fair issue. Let's do plan.
Mm.
Mm. We are also human beings. We also plan before we leave. We have families. We should also plan before we go to the work. But of course, we need the work. That is it. They will call you anytime they like.
Yeah.
And they will tell you to go. It's something the doctors should be. If there's any way they can channel it through the government workers, it's good.
Mm.
Just let all the bosses in quotes know that it's not helping at all.
Maxwell, very important contribution you make there. Now, this is what we're going to do. Just when you were talking, Maxwell, I just realized, okay, so what if the bosses don't change? Maybe there are some tips that will help us manage with the situation. So we'll get to that. Abdul, good morning to you.
Good morning.
Thank you. Thank you for holding. You're on air.
Yeah, okay. Thank you. Good morning to you. And the girl is going to talk to your good morning to your conference over there. First of all, I'm asked to come for Daniel Wicket in this country who has brought their life through the development of the country. Yes, as the last person said, majority of Ghanaian workers are successful, and then sometimes those who are ahead or who are the head of those successful, they don't usually take that into consideration. So whatever a worker is not being able to come to work as early as possible, due to maybe just this activity that is more empty, very successful. Usually, if you come to work or if you go to work, your boss will always like to see you. But then, not looking at why or what he or she can help, maybe to minimize the kind of work he or she can do to work, so that it will minimize the kind of stress that you started out in your life.
Yeah.
Let me just wrap up. In a nutshell, what I would say is that government should try as much as possible to help the new workers in order to. So that we all put our heads together and then put the list in Ghana. Especially in this system with salaries of Ghanaian workers.
Okay, all right. Yeah, that salary too can be a stressor. Abdul Fatah in Tamale, thank you very much. We'll come to Issa, and then I have a question of the boss could also be stressed. Issa is in Bole. Good morning, Issa.
Mamazi, good morning.
Good morning. Thank you for calling.
Mamazi,
yes,
I think I want to greet entire Ghanaians. Yes, Mamazi.
Okay, Issa, I see we have a situation. You have to turn down the volume on your television set,
okay,
so we don't
Mama
get any
Z,
feedback.
I think our Ghanaian future are not skilled. Both the workers and the businessmen. As I'm talking, everybody in this country is feel stressed. I mean, as a salary earner, you'll be going to work one day, they'll just tell you that, they're laying you off without even informing you officially on compensation. Secondly, this our banking system today. If I tell you how people are, people are depressed on their, it's very bad and it's pathetic. And our leaders are sitting without doing anything. I don't think Ghana can move forward at this time with these current leaders we have.
Okay,
but
Issa,
this is not political.
Yeah, that's why I wanted you to bring the conversation home, but I see where you're headed. We appreciate it, by the way. Thank you very much. Let's speak to Kelvin Adams. Kelvin is in Takrady. Good morning to you, Kelvin.
Good morning.
Yes,
sir. My situation is sometimes you have a boss at work or a manager, or sometimes they don't involve you in decision making, and when they come to work, they don't even, smile, they don't laugh, and it gets you a whole lot. Sometimes you think whether what you are doing a good, whether, I mean, you are well accepted at the work or certain things like that. So these things all get us a whole stressed up and it makes work, I mean, difficult.
Yeah. Kelvin, thank you very much. And there's something that is coming through. We will spend a bit of time on it. When you mentioned it, I didn't think it was such a big deal. But hearing others comment on that, that's being involved in decision-making or at least being communicated to. Let's speak to Kweku Kwachi. Kweku is in Akosombo. Good morning, Kweku.
Good morning, Mama V. How are you doing?
Oh, I'm very well, thank you. I hope your holiday is not as stressful.
It's okay. I think the doctor has been very, very good.
See, Akosombo is the place where you shouldn't be stressed.
Like, seriously?
Yes.
You're very stressed here.
Yes.
You simply have no idea.
Really?
Yes, we are. Why do you think we shouldn't be stressed here?
Your environment is fantastic. Just go out there. Just open the window, open the door. But please, let me allow you to speak.
You see, just like you mentioned, okay, so you can be at work for like maybe morning, like all the way to 9 in the evening before you get home. So what time do you have to do other things, wine and do other things?
Mm.
You see, the doctor has really stressed on a number of issues, and I think that it is good for all of us workers to inform some of the things that he's saying.
Mm.
Especially one thing that I find very, very important is the fact that you have a kid between age 0 to 2 years, and you are putting them in special schools that we are paying thousands of Ghana cedis for them to go to those schools, whereby we could have maybe invested those monies in educational funds and stuff like that, so that we can get them in better, maybe JSS, primary JSS, secondary schools, for them to become better people.
Mm.
Now. So I think the doctor is spot on. I'm very happy JoyNews got him this morning. I really, really enjoyed your program, and I'm grateful. Thank you very much.
All right. Thank you very much, Kweku Kwachi, and Akosombo as well. We'll come back to the phone lines, but let's get in here because Dr. Collins Ajimang is still, you've listened to a lot. I don't know what you want to pick on.
Let me just highlight some of the things that were said. We have Ghana-based stresses, and one of them is traffic.
Homegrown
stresses. Traffic can actually be a stress.
Yeah.
If you leave Akasua, works at Tema, you need to get up early. We don't stress just ourselves as employees. We stress our children because we must carry them along the workspace so that we can take them to school. We stress our husbands because we sleep late, wake up early. We stress our wives. The opposite is also true. So we have Ghanaian-based stresses. Let me also add, religious imprisonment could also be a stress.
Religious imprisonment.
Yes, Ghana, we have over 72% professing Christianity, about over 25% Islam. If we don't take care, the kinds of things we do in the name of religion will stress us. People go to church holding canes. What are they going to do? We are going to beat him. They jump, shout on top of their voice, moving to and fro. You come home tired. From the workplace, I'm don't go home. Straight. I don't want anyone to pick me wrongly. But all that I'm saying is that we need to look at some of the things we engage in all in the name of religion. Some don't even make time for their families. Some don't make time for their children. But the principles are clear. We all read the Bible. If you can't care for your home, how can you care for God's congregation? It's clear. So we need to strike a balance.
Mm.
We can have religious-based stresses. And I'm emphasizing this because many of us fall corporate to this. Ghana, we have social event that also stresses us.
Mm.
I'm going to marry one day, and we stress ourselves for a whole year.
Can you help it?
Well, you can't help it, but beyond that day, life continues. Normalcy begins. You don't wear the veil for the rest of your life. It's just for a few hours.
Mm.
We want to minimize these things. We want to take charge. And I must say, to be able to manage stress, I'm sure you ask how we can deal with some of these.
Yeah, and I thought we would jump straight there, but just to touch on, the boss could also be stressed. It looks like we're expecting a lot. and I didn't realize how are you, you know, how was your weekend, your wife just delivered, how's the baby doing?
Yeah.
I didn't realize that could go a long way, but people want to be involved, people want to be communicated to, even though they are the button.
Exactly.
But what if the boss is simply not that?
Well, I mean, that situation is also not unexpected. If you look at the hierarchy in management, the strategic apex, they are the most stressed in some cases. Decision making is complex. Mm. Decision making is difficult. Decision making, you are not even sure whether this decision we are taking will steer us the right direction or we get on the wrong path. And so at that level of management, they also get stressed as to what to do. Indecision could be a stressor.
Yeah.
And whether how am I doing, thinking about it, contemplating about it, can also be another form of stress to them. And so they also get stressed. That is why the literature, our psychological research, indicate if it is indecision, involve the people. Bring them to the table. Solicit their viewpoints. We are thinking about this. We need your views. I have been to some organizations, they have what we call the talking board or the talking wall. So there is a wall at a secluded place. Whatever your views are on a particular subject, you all have the same stickers. Write on it, pin it.
Anonymously.
At the end of the period, let's say a week, a manager or an assistant or a supervisor is tasked to collect all these, put them together. Management must sit during their executive committee meeting or whatever. Think about it, come back to the people.
Okay.
Inclusivity. We can also include them with how we introduce change. I tell you, the greatest stressor in man's life is change. You change as a boy to an adolescent to a young man, middle age, and growing old. Change is inevitable. And if you look at the workplace, all that people we spoke about, change, how we introduce them. You know, change should not be handled as an event. Mm. We need to see change as a process. And if it is a process, then we need to create change readiness when we are introducing change in our organizations. If we wake up one day as bosses and we think, this is it, this is the direction, because of management philosophy, because you are the charismatic leader who started the business, because you are in charge and this is how we should do it, you will not get the support of the people. They will sabotage you. You will not progress. At the end of the day, what would you be remembered for? Nothing. You will be remembered that, yes, at some point in our lives, we had a manager. We had an institutional head. We had a boss. That's it. But what legacies? What are your deeds? Nobody remembers you. There are situations whereby bosses leave. They come back and nobody recognizes them because of the way their management footprint. They never appeal to the sense of what? Willingness of the people. Mm. They never connected at an emotional level with the people. Mm. So it is true, bosses can get stressed. And that is where we consult, and we are there, psychologists, to help the training team, the HR unit. We need to help them bring on board some strategies to deal with all these things.
Okay, fantastic.
Yes.
Can we spend the rest of the time that we have on us as individual workers, with all the things that you outline? How do we begin to control? I can't help the fact that I have to wake up really early. I can't help the fact that I have to be here early. I can't help the fact that I have other responsibilities
that you need to show.
So how do I not get stressed?
Well, let me put it this way. What causes us stress is our reaction to events or situations. Our reactions. And so there are two ways, and I'll expand the two ways in four areas. First of all, we need to change our reaction.
Okay.
So if something happens, something is happening, can I alter it? If it is yes, let me do so. If something is happening, can I avoid it? If it is yes, let me do so. If something is happening, can I indeed totally adapt it? If it is yes, let me do so. If something is happening, can I indeed accept it? So you see, I've spoken about four A's. Mm-hmm. It's either we try to avoid, alter, mm-hmm. we adapt or accept. Four A's. And these are four key A's all of us, it could be the organization, it could be the individual, we can use to manage the stress. Mm. And these four ways are grouped under either changing our reaction. So changing our reaction, can I accept or adapt? That is my reaction to the stressor. My husband is dead. This is a stress. Can you change it? If not, you need to accept the fact that he's gone. What next? Plan toward it. Mm. If it is about someone who stresses you, you pass through this direction and all the time this gentleman waits and says, can I talk to you for a moment? Can you change your direction? Avoid that person. Mm. That is how we deal with that stress. We could also alter our lives. We need to audit ourselves and see some of the things we do that stresses us. Mm. I can have one dress, keep it well, and I'm always presentable. I can have few dresses, keep them well, and feel and look always presentable. In the media industry, as an employee, do I have to change my car every year? So 2019, I have it. 2020, January, I must register a new car. Is this my lifestyle? Can I avoid this? Can I alter how I live? That can help us. If it is about getting to work, and I always get to work late, I'm under pressure, I keep insulting my driver, I keep insulting truck drivers, why are you not speeding, why are you stopping plenty times? Why don't we leave early? Mm. That is a way we can alter that particular stressor, traffic delays. Can I use a longer route that will take me there on time? Leave early, set off early, and get there. Mm. If I have a complex boss, the point is, we ourselves must manage our emotions and manage the emotions of that person. And that is a current phenomena that is helping many people deal with all the stresses in life, emotional intelligence. My ability to manage my own emotions and then my ability to assess my boss's emotions, his reactions and all that. If I'm able to assess the way my boss reacts, how can I manage that particular emotions of my boss? Mm. To be able to adequately use these two, your own emotions management, his or your colleague's emotions management, and bringing a solution, we can say you have emotional intelligence. That is another way we can deal with the stresses. So it's simple. Let's audit ourselves. Let's take an introspection of ourselves. Managing stress is about taking charge. Mm. We must be responsible for the things that causes us stress.
Fantastic. And I think that we've ended on a perfect note. I like all the four A's that you give, and even the additions of, and today's a holiday, so it's a perfect time for you to look back into yourself and see. If there's this particular person you think doesn't like you in the office, you can either avoid, accept it, avoid if you can.
Exactly.
Change your path, possibly. Exactly.
If you can't, adapt or accept.
Okay. Yeah. But can people find you? I mean, because there are times that we've talked about this beautifully on air, which is really good. There are lots of people who have heard us. But there are times that you want to open a certain door and just have a one-on-one with someone.
Well, what I can say,
places in Ghana
you can go to.
Wait, you can't just knock on a door?
There are. If you get to any hospital when you are stressed, in most cases, the physical signs, your BP is high.
Would they take you serious if you simply came in and, you know, you were looking fine, but you just tell the nurse that I think I feel stressed?
Nurses are good at that. Sometimes somebody will come looking fine. They rush the person, jump the queue to the doctor. Patients, we don't understand. Someone is bleeding, but someone is standing doing fine. We jump the queue. It's because the BP may be so high, the next minute, this person may collapse and that is the end. Mm. And so nurses are very adept when it comes to these things. Doctors can recommend that you go and see a psychologist so that they can help you manage the stress. Psychologists are available all over. In Ghana, we have the Ghana Psychological Association. At major hospitals, district hospitals, we are there.
Okay.
Go to Rich, go to Kolebu, go to Legon Hospital. We are circulated everywhere. Mm. If you are not sure, you are in Accra, University of Ghana. The psychology department, all the faculty are psychologists. In one way or the other, we can assist you.
Okay.
Talk to someone. If you have a counseling and placement center or counseling center, you can go there. You find a counseling psychologist And let me warn, it's not everyone who can assist you to deal with these challenges. Don't just resort to anybody who calls himself or herself counselor. You should be registered by the Ghana Psychological Council. It's just like Ghana Medical Council.
Okay.
The practitioners who can help you deal with these challenges should be duly registered. So the Ghana Psychology Council must register the so-called counseling psychologist. So you can't just parade yourself, I'm a counselor, and you are all over giving wrong rapport, wrong directions, wrong strategies to people. And please, media, help us. If anybody comes and says, I'm a counselor, find out, are you registered? What is your license number from the Ghana Psychology Council? Are you part of the association? What mandate, what training do you have to say I'm a counselor?
Okay.
Because it's easy for people to become counselors.
Absolutely.
And let's avoid that.
Yeah. Thank you very much for conversation on May Day. Dr. Collins Ajiman is an industrial and organizational psychologist and the lecturer department of psychology, University of Ghana. If that is the place that is closest to you, I guess you can pop in sometime and speak to any of them. We hope that you've absolutely enjoyed this conversation, and we hope that it will begin to reflect and you can, you know, do some introspection yourself today. I want to say good morning to Mr. Peter McMenu, who is watching this stress-free conversation. And then one more dedication, and then we'll join Kojo Yang saying happy belated birthday. Dr. Mrs. Catherine Jimfua Dawson Amoa is coming from Mr. Ebenezer Obingba for Mr. Tony Dawson Amoa, your husband, Mr. Autry, and the rest of the Casa de Ropa family. They're celebrating with you. Belated birthday, Dr. Mrs. Catherine Jimfua Dawson Amoa.